Friday, people. So yesterday, I got a request to talk about early sport specialization. And this is a very passionate topic of mine, and I think everybody that's in this profession and takes the futures of our youth seriously. So I want to address this. Unfortunately for everybody that's listening and watching, I grew up watching John Madden and going to a lot of Sunday school. So I speak mainly in metaphors and parables. So get ready. This is going to be far-fetched. But here's the bottom line. Sports specialization, early sports specialization works. And so you're probably shocked to hear me say that. That's not the point. The problem is when it does work, you create things that are hard to reverse and create situations that are very difficult and sometimes impossible to correct. So let me give you an example. Let me give you a metaphor that is going to kind of further explain this for parents that are making decisions, because I don't think any parents out there looking to destroy the future for their kid through early sports specialization, they're just trying to do what's right. Most of the time, they're pressured by what other people are doing and they feel like they need to keep up, fear of missing out, all this. So let's put that to the side for a second, and let me give you an example of a story that could paint a picture of why, one, early sports specialization works, and two, why it's a very, very bad idea. So let's say that you're a parent of a kid that loves remote control cars, and you've decided you're gonna get a remote control car, but you're gonna customize it, and you're gonna customize it like it's never been done before. You're gonna go all in on this thing. Well, when you start to customize a remote control car, what would be very important is, where is that remote control car going to go? So if you're in East Texas, where I live, let's say that the grass and the terrain is a certain way. So let's say that you have Bermuda grass and it's really short. And let's say in your backyard, it's an L-shaped backyard, and you want to customize this. You can't be in the front. So it's a customized remote control car. Well, what you're going to do is, number one, that machine, first of all, is going to go left a lot. So you've got to make sure if you're customizing this car, it's going to go left, and then on the way back, it's probably going to circle around and go right. So you're going to have a front right tire problem. You're going to have a back left tire problem. So what's going to happen is your bearings are going to wear out in those two areas. It doesn't matter if it's a really good remote control or not, car or not. Those bearings are going to wear out. There's also suspension issues. If you truly want to customize it, you need to customize it to the track that it's going on. Now, furthermore, it needs to be a certain type of remote control car to work in your backyard specifically. There's very specific things about your backyard that are different than your neighbor's backyard. And even if you did go to your neighbor's backyard, it's still East Texas. Now, I can continue with this metaphor, but the gist of it is, if you do the same things over and over again, it doesn't matter how good the machine is, you're going to wear out bearings that are being overused for that machine in the same movements, in the same directions. So it doesn't matter. Now, we're different than machines in that we adapt, but we still also, through those adaptations, create tissue development that is sometimes irreversible. And those types of things can create time bombs in the body. When you hit puberty, you can actually get hurt because of things that you did in your youth. So I'm digressing. Let's say that you built this remote control car, you completely customize the suspension, you completely customize the way that the car travels in the Bermuda grass, the way it turns left and goes around the track in your backyard specifically. Now let's say, now you get transferred to Colorado Springs, Colorado. Now, that remote control car is virtually useless because your backyard now is rough terrain. Let's say that instead of cutting left, it goes straight down, and instead of grass, you have a lot of rocks and you have some different vegetation. And now what's happened is you have customized and fully gone in early sports specialization and adapted something to something that now is no longer applicable. That is the exact same thing you do when you do early sports specialization with a child. You are creating a very narrow base for them that they're gonna operate on for the rest of their life. And unfortunately, during these small windows, you don't get that time back. So your body is adapting tissues, neurological processes, and the way that the body is formed around objectives that you're putting in front of them. Unfortunately, if you're just putting in front of them how to field a ball from shortstop, you're going to be really limited when they get older if they need to do something else, much less in the game of baseball as a human being. So we've got to build adaptable athletes that can do a multitude of different jobs and different things. You need to build a diverse maps and pathways to where instead of someone only being able to go down to Nacogdoches, they know that like the back of their hand, they better be able to travel the state of Texas, the world. And when you do early sports specialization, it's no different than teaching someone one route or teaching someone how to operate a remote control car that works perfectly just for their backyard. You're self-sabotaging them into limiting their opportunities and choices later in life. And so you've got to understand that just the reality is sports specialization does work. If it didn't, the Chinese wouldn't dominate youth sports. But the problem is it peaks you so early, I mean before puberty, that you cannot go back and get those windows of development for other athletic attributes. That's why playing so many sports is important. You know, go back to the remote control car analogy. Ideally, if a parent had all the information and knew what was best for their kid, they would build a remote control car that is so robust it could work in any terrain. Now, does that mean it's best for street racing? Probably not, but it can still compete. Does that mean it's best for climbing straight up a mountain? Probably not, but it can still do it. But at the end of the day, you can focus on more specialization when you know where your actual location for a lifetime is going to be. Now, that's a metaphor. What I mean is when you've actually reached your destination at the end of puberty, you're going to know what direction to go specialize in. That it'll be revealed to you. And at that point, if you have options, if you're a versatile human, if you're a versatile athlete, you can specialize and you're going to have a higher level of opportunity in the area and the direction that you go in, even within that sport. And so I'm sorry to kind of go off on some tangents and rant, but I just want to come in these types of things. I just want to be real and talk through it. I don't want to script, and you know, it's something that's passionate to me, and I think it's difficult to understand. We could go into you know, development of you know, the subtalar joint, neurological responses, peak height velocity versus peak weight velocity. You guys don't care about that. The bottom line is early sports specialization is a double-edged sword, and it only ends one way. It only ends one way, and that way is in limitation. If you don't believe me, just go look at the statistics of kids that play in the Little League World Series versus the amount of those kids that even play varsity baseball. It's staggering, and there's psychological implications that I'm not even talking about on here that could be even more impactful, more important than the physiological implications and serious nature of this as well. So don't take my word for it. Do your own research. This is something that we've been forced to acknowledge, not something that we just want to beat your head with. It doesn't benefit us. Sports specialization would actually be a lot better for our business because we could train a kid in all the months they're not playing. So this isn't an initiative that helps me financially. It's an initiative that is near and dear to my heart, and that is, you know, at the core of our mission, we're here to protect futures and improve lives to the field of human performance. And if we're not sharing the truth and we're not telling parents and empowering parents to make good decisions with their kids, then fundamentally we're not doing what we're here for. So if anybody's got any other questions, or if anybody wants to suggest other topics in the future, please let me know. I'd love to, you know, start doing these pretty much every day and talking about stuff that parents are having concerns or struggling with or seeing trends or really anything, man. I want to provide value for people out there that we can't always be in contact with. So I'm going to start posting these on a Team APEC page, and I'll put a link to that here so that way that people can share it. I'm maxed out on friends, so I can't, not everybody can, I think you can share this, but not everybody can see it all the time. So I'm going to start posting these on a Team APEC page, which is just a corporate page. So you guys have a great Friday. We made it. Appreciate everybody for tuning in. Hopefully this helps some people. Please tag them or share with as many people as we can. Thanks.